Hey everybody. Okay, so I'm here to bring you my week of my year 2017 for February. And actually my week is sort of the end of February, the month of love and celebration and that sort of thing, and the beginning of March, which is the beginning of spring and all of that. I'm not going to give you the March prompt. That's going to happen on Sunday. Work in my journal, and I'm going to decorate my February signature, which I haven't done yet, and I am going to focus for me on not only celebrating, of course, you know, Valentine's Day and love for my family and my husband, but I also think the month of February and Valentine's Day should also be a reminder to those of us, whether you have a partner or not, or family or not, to love yourself. If you can't love and be comfortable with yourself, in my opinion, it's going to be difficult for you to love other people and be happy if you aren't truly happy with yourself first. So that should be part of this month. So let's go ahead and let's work on our journal. I've got a bunch of bits and pieces here that I'll show you. This is what we have. And I have been traveling with this. I took it to Creativation with me and it made it just fine. This is the Shaker dashboard I did that I have already shared in the group, inspired by the video from Anna Brim. And the link is already out there. I will try to remember to link it in the description below the video. This was a lot of fun to make and really easy. I did use a fuse tool and did just what she did. I do have some ideas on how to do one without a fuse tool and maybe refillable. So I am working on that, and hopefully that's going to be one of the videos that I do for this week. And this is our February signature, and it's just very basically decorated. There isn't, you know, much to it. What's on here is just what's on here from when I made it. And this is the back side of the Shaker dashboard. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to decorate that. The first thing that we need to do is I need to print a book club list, a book review list. So I'm going to do that, and I'm going to get a tag, and I'll be right back. And I thought it would, because I couldn't remember where I put the file on my computer for the printable book lists and to-do lists and other documents. In our My Year 2017 group, if you go to the files section, there is a file for free downloads, and the link for these are in there. And now let's get out some blue dot runner, which is my new favorite thing, and some scissors. Because we're just going to wing it and cut it out by hand. I have a Ranger number 10 Manila craft tag that I'm going to put this on, and then we're going to tip it in. You're not here. I wish you were. I am going to tip it into my journal to get started for my month. Let's see. I do have some cool tape around here somewhere that I want to use that I just got. I have one with hearts on it that I've been using, but I have this new one with butterflies on it that's really cute. So I didn't really need it. I needed it like a hole in the head, but it's super cute. I couldn't resist. Okay. So this works just like a tape runner. Only it leaves glue dot squares on your piece that you're gluing. Okay. So see, glue dot squares. I was introduced to it and used it at Creativation in Phoenix, and I love it. Okay. So that works great. And I'll put a list of everything that we're using today in my materials list for January. And there'll be a January materials list in the files, so you can go over there. and also the link to all the videos for February. Did I say January? I meant February. The link for all the February videos will be in a separate document, which will also be over there. So now before I tip this in, do I want to do it before or after? Because I'm going to be sticking some tape on here. I might want to do it after. I want to decorate it with some of my love-themed things, but I think first we want to tip it in. Now, sometimes washi tape is traditionally a low tack tape. So what does that mean? That means that you may find that you have to put some matte medium underneath the tape. And honestly, I do usually do that. I'm going to get some deli paper out first, but any scrap piece of paper will work. And I'm going to just stick that in there so I don't get matte medium all over the place. And I'm going to put a little bit of matte medium. Maybe I am. With a brush. There we go. And kind of take some of it and stick it over here. Oops. You could use glue. You could use a lot of things. Matte medium's easy and it dries pretty quickly. There we go. And you leave a little, like, teeny bit of a gap between the signature and the tag. Just like, not even an eighth of an inch, just a little bit of a gap there. And then push that down good. And then turn it over. Whoops. See? Yeah, and once it dries, it'll stick well. But it has to really dry on there. Okay, so then I'm going to turn it over gently. Put some more matte medium on the other side. When I'm traveling with my journal and I have to do this, I either make sure I bring tape that I don't have to do this with, or I do bring a small jar of actually gel medium instead of matte medium, which takes longer to dry, but travels better because it's more of a gel and less of a liquid. And you don't have to worry about it exploding in your suitcase. I've also used things like Elmer's glue in a pinch, and it's worked good. You just want some extra kind of glue or adhesive between the tape and what you're taping it to, because the adhesive on the washi tape is probably not strong enough to keep your tipping in. There we go. Let's give that a quick dry. So now, I have all these bits and pieces. I have some heart confetti. I have this really pretty napkin that has this beautiful pink flower on it. I have some heart washi tape sheets. I have some heart die cuts that I did. The video is a bonus video for this week. They're very simple to do. You probably already know how to do them. I have one thing that I need to from some, my car got in an accident last month and it's being worked on this month. I had to rent a rental car, which was kind of a process. So this has to, at least this part of it has to go in here because it was a thing that happened this month. I have some love and heart doodles. I found this little love postcard in some bits and pieces when I was working on my tray for my grab and glue journal. I've got some heart stickers. My art snacks bookmark, which I need to put in here. I found, again, this little bit and piece that said be mine on it when I was going through my stuff. And this clear heart dashboard. And this little piece that I did this month for the design team challenge. So all of those things I want to use in here. So we are going to spend some time decorating our journal. Our, I said our again, see? And on these, I don't even think I'm going to color them. I think I just want to put them in here the way they are, black and white. So I'm going to speed forward through the process so you guys can see how I put these bits and pieces in my journal. And I'll be back at the end with a little bit of a chat. All right. Okay, so here's how I've decorated my journal so far for the month. I'm just going to do a little quick flip through. Again, this is only like the second week in February that I'm filming this, so by the time you actually see my week, this is going to probably look very different because it'll be filled up with journaling and everything, and I will be closing my week with a flip of my completed journal for February. Just so you all know, so you all can get a good look at what it looks like when it's all finished. So, but there's how it looks right now. And what we're going to do next, before we do any journaling or anything, is I want to do a quick little art piece to put in the journal. So I'm going to use, of course, my Pilot Varsity disposable fountain pen, which y'all know if you've been watching me on YouTube for a while, I love. So let's zoom in a little bit. And we're going to just do nothing, you know, nothing complicated. I'm going to actually draw some hearts, just doodle some hearts on here. Messy doodles at that. This is an ATC sized piece of watercolor paper. Old, stained, kind of dingy watercolor paper, which personally I think is interesting. Oops, I don't know how to spell. It's a good thing I expect it to be messy. All right, so now we're going to get just this, just a small Princeton Select pointed filbert number 4 brush. So you have kind of the benefits of a flat and a pointed round brush at the same time. I've got my Daniel Smith metallic palette out here. I've already got it wet. the first thing I want to do is activate some of the Pilot Varsity pen. And here's a great tip for you. If you do something like I did and you spell a word wrong, you know, when you're using a water-soluble pen, just put a little water on there and, you know, do some drippy, messy design things, and then it'll make it work. Just kind of blends it in. So before I do anything else, I want to dry this. And drying it doesn't mean it won't smear and blend with the watercolor paint, but it will do it less if it's completely dry. Now, of course, if you don't have a heat tool, you don't like using a heat tool with your water-soluble materials, that's perfectly fine. Some watercolorists don't. You can just leave it after you do the blending of the pen part and then come back to it. So I'm going to take now, this is hibiscus, which is a pink, metallic pink. And like I said, it's going to pick up some of that blue-gray color of the pen, but not as much as if I still had it wet. You can see that it's picking, it's turning it purpley-gray in some places. I'm okay with that. And this color is Ruby that I'm going to pick up now, which is obviously a red color. And I'm going to just drop a little bit of that in here. And then we do have a couple of shades of green. I'm going to pick the one that's called Ocean, which is a blue-green. Real pretty duochrome color. You could, of course, do like we did last month and do this on a bookmark. You could actually do this on a page in your journal. Just have fun and do some experimenting with some of your materials and see what you come up with. Just do something really quick and easy. I want to dry that again. I'm going to take some of my favorite Bible High Glider gel crayons, gel sticks, and I'm going to add a little bit. Pink and green. Just like that. I love that. That looks great. So we're gonna stick this in our journal, and I'm gonna put it right here. If it'll fit, yep. There we go. So I'm going to spend some time journaling about the process of renting the car for my that I needed to have while my car was having its body work done, which was quite a process. And journaling about this nice, very nice, lovely note I got from a fan group member here in my year, 2017. And she sent me a copy of one of last month's book review books I had borrowed from my friend Cindy Utter. And I loved it so much, I did return it to her, because that's what we do when we borrow some things. But I did comment that I really loved the book and that I might have to get my own copy because I really kind of wanted to go through and highlight some passages. And she said, you know what, I have that book, I'd be happy to send it to you. So she did, so thank you so much. And so I'll be journaling about that. And of course we have the book review coming up. And I'm sure there's other things coming up. I gotta write about this month's art snacks. And yeah, I can't wait to fill it up at the end of the month and see what happens. I will be back at the end of this week that you're watching this right now with the completed signature and a flip. I also am going to work on my idea for a refillable non-fuse tool required shaker card. We'll see what happens. All right, that's it for today. Go out, have some fun with this month's prompt. Journal about love, loving yourself, loving your family, loving your friends, your partner, loving life. And have fun with it. And, you know, feel free to film it, share it, any of those things. We would love to see what you're doing over in the Facebook group, so please join if you haven't already, and share your pictures of your projects, share your YouTube link if you've made a YouTube link with demoing what you've done with this month's prompt. Just be sure to use our hashtag #MyYear2017 and mention the group. That's all we ask, is to give credit where credit's due, and otherwise you're free to share at will. And that's it for right now. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe, please. And if you can, support my YouTube channel by shopping in my Etsy shop. That would be great. But the most important thing is to go out and have a great day. Do something nice for yourself, because you deserve it, and I'll see you later. Bye, guys.